back here with you alongside Ron Neamey for this huge main event. Eddie Edwards accidentally misspoke. It is not for the Florida Unified Heavyweight title, but rather for the IPW World Heavyweight title held by Lex Lovett. And he's taking on Freedom Rider Mike Sullivan. I don't know, but still your NWA Florida Heavyweight Champion at ringside with Mike Sullivan, Scoot Andrews.
This promises to be a hell of a match, Aaron Royal. Lex Lovett, your IPW World Heavyweight Champion, as you said, facing the former four-time IPW Heavyweight Champion, who promises to be a hell of a match.
But what is going on with the Alliance of Defiance? We saw earlier in the night before Bruce Steele now wrestled Justice. Much dissension in the Alliance of Defiance, mainly between Rod Steele and Mike Sullivan over this whole Freedom Rider persona.
Rod Steele, not the type of guy that can ever get along with anybody. The fans can't stand him. The referees can't stand him. The own members of the Alliance of Defiance seem to be pointing the finger at Rod Steele, seem to be blaming him for everything that has went wrong in the past couple months in the camp of the Alliance of Defiance. I don't like Rod Steele, but the guy can't take all the blame.
He certainly can't. You see Lex Lovett and Mike Sullivan feeling each other out. Mike Sullivan able to get a quick advantage, push Lex Sullivan to the corner, but Lex immediately grabbing ahead. These guys having a very slow, methodical match. You don't see this very often, Ron Neamey, but that just shows the respect that these two guys have for each other.
Again, you talk about respect. Both of these competitors have traveled the world over. Lex Lovett, a true world champion, defending that title in Japan as well as here in the United States for IPW Hardcore Wrestling. He has toured in Peru. Mike Sullivan has been all over Puerto Rico, Peru, Japan, the United States. He has been at Madison Square Garden, living out that lifelong dream of wrestling for the WWE in Madison Square Garden last year.
Make no mistake about it. Part of the reason these two guys being so careful, trying to feel each other out, they do not want to make a mistake. They want that IPW World Heavyweight title, the most prestigious belt in independent wrestling today. Mike Sullivan, he's held that belt on four occasions. He wants to make it five, and he knows Lex Lovett does not have to beat Mike Sullivan. But if Mike Sullivan wants that title, he does have to beat Lex Lovett.
Lovett has said that his IPW World Heavyweight title reign will be a re-education of the fans here in Florida. He says he's bringing back the wrestling here in IPW Hardcore Wrestling. And with Steve Madison, the Modern Miracle, as a TV champion, Aaron, I can't think of two better examples to bring back the old school style made famous here in Florida for decade after decade. As a matter of fact, Lex Lovett actually trained as well as Steve Madison, trained by the Gator Steve Kern. I don't like Steve Kern. Not a big fan of the Steve Kern School of Hard Knocks, but these two are obviously on the top of their game.
Obviously, nobody here watching IPW right now a fan of the School of Hard Knocks, but we did see the WrestlePlex students, Mikey Batch, Hot Ass Amy Love, led by Eric Stevens. They came in, they ran down David Mercury, Stash, and T-Bolt, ran them right out of the ring. WrestlePlex students standing tall, and that's because they're the most well-trained students in Florida today.
That is a fact. You hit it right on the head. The WrestlePlex is the place. If you want to come to learn to be a professional wrestler, I suggest you call 727-526-6778, or you go to ipw-hardcore.com. Lex Lovett, he may have been trained by Steve Kern at the School of Hard Knocks, but he has taken the modern style. He's taken from Japan and from Puerto Rico and from all over the world, and he's meshed it into an unbelievable wrestling machine that you look in the ring. That's why he's the IPW World Heavyweight Champion, and look at him working the leg of the Freedom Rider.
Definitely trying to take out the wheel of the Freedom Rider, reminiscent of maybe the Andersons of years past. If you can take out one of your opponent's limbs, they're going to be that much less successful against you in the ring. Lex Lovett meshing the American and Japanese styles very, very well. As you said, that's why he's the World Heavyweight Champion. It was a long time in coming for Lex Lovett to get a belt here in IPW, but he's doing this all proud. But the guy that held that title before, Scoot Andrews, we haven't seen him in pay-per-view yet, but trust me, he is on the outside of the ring backing up Mike Sullivan, but you know damn well he wants that title back himself, and he also wants to get his hand on the guy that broke his arm, Antonio Banks.
Gertrude Andrews has made it very clear his intention, and that is to reunify the IBW World Heavyweight Championship and the NWA Florida Heavyweight Championship. You want to talk about a proud history, the NWA Florida Heavyweight title, currently held by Scoot Andrews. That belt has been around for what seems to be the beginning of time. Scoot has made it very clear. First, he's going to break the leg, arm, or neck of Antonio Banks. Then he's coming after Lovett. Look at that beautiful drop kick right to the knee of the Freedom Rider, who's in all kinds of trouble. Beautiful leg whip by Lex Lovett.
Again, working over the leg of Mike Sullivan. And I haven't seen anybody be able to take it to Mike Sullivan. Actually wrestling like Lex Lovett is here tonight. Maybe this new Freedom Rider persona not working out as well as he would have hoped. He came up a bit short against the Navy SEAL. You saw that here on TV last week. Those two again putting on a classic, and he's coming up short tonight. And speaking of classics, Ron Neamey, you talked about Rod Steele earlier. Mikey Tenderfoot still not back from the injury sustained during that match, but he did win that I Quit match with Rod Steele. Very early contender for match of the year here in IPW.
Mikey Tenderfoot making a huge name for himself, unbeknownst to Rod Steele. I have to say, he's made a name for himself on the name of Rod Steele. He destroyed Rod Steele, if you listen to Mikey Tenderfoot. But the truth of the matter is, Mikey Tenderfoot is still at home, just released from the hospital very recently, still licking his wounds, still trying to get back in tip-top form. Mikey Tenderfoot, the type of guy that'd get in the ring even if he's only at 50%, but the doctors would not allow him. They would not give him the medical relief to come to the WrestlePlex tonight to compete. You know Mikey Tenderfoot's got to be at home licking his chops with a huge win in that I Quit match over Rod Steele, ready to make his return to IPW.
All right, Ron Neamey, Mikey Tenderfoot will be very busy in the upcoming weeks, and we'll talk about that momentarily. But right now, Lex Lovett temporarily letting up on the leg of Mike Sullivan, going to go for another type of attack perhaps. Both guys on their feet, and Ron Neamey, Mike Sullivan, he has a huge match coming up September the 27th, 7th Avenue Slaughter, 2003, the 9 p.m. start, board your ride, IPW back in Ybor City.
You want to talk about a traveling champion, Lex Lovett will defend that belt in Japan. Tiger Ittori, he's got as much invested into Lex Lovett being the man running World Japan Pro Wrestling with Riki Choshu. He knows that he's got one of the best of the best when he's got your IPW World Heavyweight Champion, Lex Lovett. That's why he's main eventing almost every single night in over in Japan. They want to team with him. They want to go against him. They know that this kid got what it takes. And it doesn't matter if it's in Davie, Florida, where we will be tomorrow night. It doesn't matter if, like you said, September 27th, a special 9 p.m. belt. Look at that beautiful jump right to the face of Lex Lovett. You see the Freedom Rider using the advantage, using that veteran-like status that he has to take Lex Lovett to the mat. Beautiful front face lock. I think he's actually choking the life on him.
I didn't see that whatsoever, Ron Neamey. These two guys so evenly matched. Neither guy at all able to gain a decisive edge thus far. And I have to believe, Ron Neamey, with the type of wrestlers these guys are, no matter who comes out the winner, they will do the right thing. We've been talking about titles and rankings, and the only thing to do based on who should be ahead in the rankings is for the winner of this match to face Dennis Smitty at night with everything he's got going on, including that pretty tattoo of a butterfly. He got a psychotic
too. Oh, yeah, you're a big, big fan of Dennis Knight. You've made that very clear here tonight. And you know, we're making our huge debut up in Ocala. Big surprise, IPW Hardcore Wrestling expanding to Ocala, October 18th. We're going to Skate Mania. I guarantee you that roller rink is going to double as one of the most insane wrestling grounds that Ocala has ever seen. And Lex Lovett, with an open contract for October 18th, maybe Dennis Smitty Knight will sign his name on that contract. Because I guarantee you, whether it's at the Born to Ride Saloon on September 27th, whether it's back at the WrestlePlex on October 11th, or whether it's October 18th at Skate Mania in Ocala, Lex Lovett, your IPW World Heavyweight Champion, if he comes away with the belt this match, will be there.
Whoever comes away with this belt, as we said, they should face a guy like Midian. Obviously, many other contenders, Scoot Andrews, Antonio Banks, Agent Bruce Seville. I tell you what, though, I hate to say it, he did not fare too well earlier tonight, losing to Justice, who's really, really working his way up it that way. But boy, did Bruce Steele get back over later on. And he had a surprising score for Tiffany in the form of Lennox.
It seems like Bruce Steele is more concerned with his former secretary, Tiffany, than chasing either the IPW World Heavyweight title or the NWA Florida Heavyweight title. You've named some of the top contenders here in IPW. You can't forget some of the stars, like the Big Wiggle himself, Norman Smiley. You got Danny Doring and the huge monster from South Florida, the Punisher. Who in the hell can get in the way of the Punisher and stop that 7-foot, 350-pound monster when he sets his sights on a title?
I would dare say Dennis Midian Knight, but I believe I've made that point abundantly clear so far, Ronini. We've talked about how great our show's been tonight, but next week, Ronini, two big matches announced. It's going to be the Navy SEAL and Cuban Assassin taking on the Midnight Freebirds, and another big tag match, Mike Sullivan, who you see in the ring, teaming up with Scoot Andrews to take on Mikey Tenderfoot and Justin.
You want to talk about two main events in any arena throughout the entire country, you're talking about it right there, right here, next week on IPW Hardcore Wrestling. And Aaron, I hate to see her and Mark out, but the Born to Ride Saloon during the Ybor City Bike Fest, September 27th, 9 p.m., we got the return to IPW of the Madman from the Sudan himself, Abdullah the Butcher, taking on the Prince of Darkness, Kevin Sullivan. You want to talk, look at that beautiful suplex, taking over Freedom Rider, Lex Levin. I'm busy talking about Sullivan. I'm busy talking about Abdullah. I didn't even bring up New Jack. I haven't talked about the bloodshed spilled by New Jack and Chaos. And they will meet again on September 27th. Lex Lovett trying to take care of business as only he can do in the ring. Referee Jim Bragg, 87 years old, keeping up with every bit of this match. The fans, like I said, being re-educated to what these two men excel at, and that is wrestling.
They certainly do, Ronini. Two of the best around, and you see some of the wear and tear of going this long in a match thus far without really trying to put your opponent away is coming to light. Both men falling down exhausted, but Lex Lovett taking the worst of it right now. Mike Sullivan, the Freedom Raider paint all but off as it's melted away under the hot light here at the Florida Wrestleplex. And look at the big suplex by Mike Sullivan, just laying out your champion, Lex Lovett. I dare say it's going to be 2-1 tonight for the AOG.
Unbelievable strength displayed by the Freedom Rider, Mike Sullivan, setting up Lex Lovett with a beautiful vertical suplex and then adding insult to injury, only using one arm, and then he discards Lex Lovett, your champion, like last week's sack of potatoes. That's absolutely disgusting. He's playing with the head of Lovett.
We could never, ever get through an IPW. Oh, look at that. Scoot Andrews taking out his frustration on one of his new enemies, actually a renewed enemy, and Lex Lovett taking him to one post. Gets a chair right across the back of Lex Lovett. I tell you, referee Jim Bragg needs to pay attention. Everybody knows that I love the Elijah the Fire, but this is a match for the IPW World Heavyweight title, and the referee has got to know what's going on.
The Alliance of Defiance, even during these times of adversity, working like a well-oiled machine. Scoot Andrews standing at ringside, has the cast still on his arm, but that doesn't prevent him from taking the steel chair and slamming it onto the back of your champion. Freedom Rider Mike Sullivan sees the opening and lays in a wicked chop.
Nobody chops him like Mike Sullivan, and another one. Lex Lovett trying to shake it off, but you can't just shake off chops from Mike Sullivan. But Lovett firing right back. Another one. These guys trading chops back and forth, Ronini. One of these guys has got to give out pretty soon.
Eventually, the temper's got to flare, and you see they're letting it all hang out right now. Trading some wicked chops. Sullivan going for another vertical suplex. Sets the champion up on the ring corner. What the hell is he going to do? Mike Sullivan, known for one of the most wicked superplexes in the entire business. Is that what he's setting him up for, Aaron?
It certainly looks like it. If I was calling it like Gordon Foley, we'd call it the super play. But let's see if he's doing it right now. Shades of Barry Windham, as I like to call it. But Lex Lovett fighting right back, pushing him off the top rope. If we knew it was coming, so did Lex Lovett.
Lex Lovett obviously been studying. Look at that beautiful dropkick, and actually lands on his feet. Comes over, hooks the leg like a true champion, only a 2.5 count. Freedom Rider Mike Sullivan has the presence of mind to kick out of the pinfall combination. Lex Lovett not showing any frustration whatsoever. The guy looks like he's actually got his second win, and now he's going up to the top.
He's going back up, maybe a blockbuster here. What's he
love it.
Lex Lovett taking far too much time on that top rope, and Freedom Rider Mike Sullivan capitalizes on the opportunity. Lex Lovett sent crashing down groin first to the corner post. He's got to be hurting. Mike comes up, takes him up and over. Look at that beautiful field throw slash suplex combination.
Right off the top rope, and Mike Sullivan just as exhausted as Lex Lovett is right now. You see the ecstasy Jenny Lee out at ringside trying to cheer on her man to IPW World Heavyweight title number 5. He's also been the hardcore champion when he unified those titles. He's a multiple-time tag team champion, but nothing satisfies him like being the world champ.
Nothing does satisfy. Look at that beautiful Lex Buster taking over to Freedom Rider. And you actually see Jenny Lee get. Look at the Lex.
I haven't seen her that excited since she got that Ron Neiman Loves Me tattoo from our friends over at Psychotic Inc. on 4th Street in St. Peter.
Yeah, that goes right up there in the lower with your 3-win streak on that tally. But look at Gigolo Jim Bragg over there. Paying no attention to the match. And hitting Lex Lovett right there with the cast is Stuart Andrews. He said there was payback for Lex Lovett and Antonio Banks, and it looks like it started tonight.
Come on, Jim Bragg, get out of the corner. Quit. The guy's over there trying to hit on the beautiful, and it looks like we're going to... He actually got out of the pinfall combination. His head is busted open. Jim Bragg, as I said, too busy occupying himself, hitting on the beautiful slash. Bust the ecstasy, Jenny Lee, and he didn't notice. Scoot Andrews coming in with that cast. And absolutely special. There he is again. Enough, Scoot Andrews. Scoot Andrews setting up your champion for what looks like another huge, going for the forces of nature. And it's Antonio Banks. Comes in with a clubber and blow across the Black Nature Boy's back. And now he hits him, breaking the bank with Antonio Banks. Levels Scoot Andrews, takes him out. Freedom Rider has no clue what's going on. Takes the boot to the midsection, up and over. This could be it.
This could be it. Not good right now for Mike Sullivan. But Jim Bragg, still distracted by ecstasy Jenny Lee. You have to wonder how he didn't hear what was going on. Is he conveniently turning his back? Did Jenny Lee get to him before this match?
Come on, Jim Bragg. Come. Hey, what the hell is he holding up for? That was a 3 count. You look at the blood splattered all over the canvas like a Chicago-style slaughterhouse. Let's love it. Spilling the crimson mask all over his face. Freedom Rider, like a hungry wolf, can smell the blood and goes right to work on Lex Lovett.
Lex Lovett reverses. He's got to do the rope. No, Lex Lovett reverses again. Oh, slap drop by Lex Lovett. 1, 2. Oh, I thought he retained the title right there, Ronnie.
What an incredible heavyweight title match. You look at the massive bloodshed by the IPW World Heavyweight Champion, Lex Lovett. He's not fazed whatsoever. He still holds the upper hand over the Freedom Rider, Mike Sullivan. Scoops up for a tombstone-style pile driver. This could be it for Sullivan, who reverses it and is going for a pile driver of his own. Beautifully executed.
That has to be it. How much can these guys take? But apparently, just a little bit more. Lex Lovett, once again, getting the shoulder off.
You want to talk about intestinal fortitude and all kinds of other wrestling cliches. This match has every single one of them. Unbelievable violence, unbelievable technical expertise. This match has it all, Aaron Royal.
What it doesn't have yet is a clear-cut winner. Mike Sullivan again shot off the ropes, ducks the clothesline from Lex Lovett. Lex reverses, shoots off Sullivan again, drops to hole. What's he going into now, Ron Neary?
Look at him bridging it to, looks like an SPF type deal. Got him locked in, wrenching down on the neck and the leg of the Freedom Rider. Referee Jim Bragg right there asks him. He says, do you give? Are you going to pass out? It's got to be over for Freedom Rider.
This doesn't... His arm dropped 3 times, Ron Neary. That's it. Just like Mikey Tenderfoot wouldn't give up a few weeks ago to Ron Steele, and he passed out. Now Mike Sullivan passing out. He would not give up in a world title match. Man, we've got to cut out of here. Still, your world heavyweight champion, Lex Lovett. And don't forget to look out for Aaron Royal's big surprise.